Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part six of an equation of a circle. We're going to do this problem. Write the equation of the circle in standard form. State the center and radius of the circle. State any x-intercepts and y-intercepts. And graph it. So we're being asked to do a lot of things. So the first thing we notice is that we don't have a circle in standard form. In fact, the directions are to write the equation in standard form. Remember that this is not really in what we usually think general form looks like. So general form, remember what we wrote? X squared plus y squared plus ax plus bx plus c equals 0. And as long as not all of a, b, and c were 0, this would be a circle. And so when you look at this equation up here, you notice it has 3x squared and 3y squared. It doesn't just have x squared plus y squared. So the first thing I'm going to point out is if you have the same coefficient exactly for the x squared and y squared term, you can divide both sides of the equation by that coefficient to make it look like this general form. So for instance, since they both are 3, I could divide the left side of the equation by 3, and then of course the right side as well, to just get an x squared plus y squared plus whatever else it happens to be. So even though we write the general form like this, you could modify it slightly and say, well, we can have, let's just call it another letter, D and E. Oh, I'm sorry. Write the same coefficient. If these are the same coefficient, then actually it's really close to general form, okay? Because if you divide everything by D, you'd have it look like the first way I expressed it. So now, let's go ahead and think about what that looks like if I divided everything by 3. Right, so if I divide the left side by 3, remember all we have to do is divide each term by 3. And we do that on both sides of the equation. And that will give me x squared plus y squared plus 2x equals 0. That's in general form because remember, as long as we have at least one other thing besides x squared plus y squared, when you have 0 on the right, then it's in general form. So I could say that's plus 0y and plus 0, for instance. That's fine. So our next step would be to put it in standard form. Remember, we're trying to get it into standard form, is we want to group the x terms together, the x squared and the 2x term together, because we're going to have to complete the square. So we'll put the x squared plus 2x plus something to get that a perfect square. And we would want to group the y squared term with the y term. There is no y term, so this is awesome. We could just leave this as y squared. If you want, you could write that as y minus 0 y squared, but it's easier to just leave that as y squared. What this means is the y coordinate of the center will be 0. Okay? So in other words, k is 0. And then we have this 0 on the other side. Now I'm going to put a plus a blank because whatever I add over here on the left, I'm going to have to add it also on the right. So let's go ahead and complete the square. So what will go in here? We've got an x to get the x squared, and then we've got for our middle term plus 2. X. So we have to take half of that coefficient. So half of plus 2 is plus 1, which means what you would have to add up here is the 1 squared or 1. So I am adding 1 to both sides. Right? There it is. That's what I'm adding to both sides. I still have plus y squared, and over here I have 1, and I now have the equation of a circle in standard form. You don't have to write y minus 0. It's in standard form to just write y squared as long as there's no y term. And on the right, you've got x plus 1, But remember, you could write that so that you could see the radius. One is the same thing as one squared. So there we have it in standard form, either of these two are standard form. You'll see some people always write it where you have the something squared. Some will just simplify it and write the actual number here. So then we need to find the center and the radius. So what is the center? Okay, so remember, if it's x plus 1, the x coordinate is negative 1. If you forget what to do, just take what's being squared, in other words, what's in parentheses, x plus 1, set it equal to 0, and that'll tell you what to put in for your x coordinate. And for your y coordinate, since it's just y squared, we've got 0. And what's the radius? The radius is 1. So we've got our center and our radius. Now, at this point, you could graph it, right? Which is one of the things you're being asked to do. Let's go ahead and do that because it's going to be easy to graph. So there's negative 3, it's positive 3, etc. All right, so we've got for our center, it's over here at negative 1, 0. I'm just going to put a little dot here. That's not part of the circle. And the radius is 1. So we are going to go from there up 1, down 1, to the right 1, to the left 1. And by looking at the picture, you can see what the x-intercepts and the y-intercepts are. In fact, the x-intercepts are negative 2, 0, and 0, 0. So the x-intercepts are negative 2, 0, and 0, 0. And the y-intercept is also just 0, 0. It's the same point, right? Because the origin, 0, 0, is on both. So in this case, by graphing it first, it was really easy to see what the x-intercept and the y-intercept was. Now, if you wouldn't have graphed it first, you can find the x and y-intercepts by putting in 0 for x to find the y-intercept and 0 for y to put in the x-intercept. So let's go ahead and take our original equation and do that. So here is our original equation, 3x squared plus 3y squared plus 6x equals 0. We could plug it in there, but it's actually easier to divide by 3 and then go ahead and plug it into this modified equation after we divide it by 3. And so let's plug x equals 0 in, 0 in for x to figure out the y-intercepts, right? For the y-intercepts, you'll let x equal 0. So that will give you 0 squared plus y squared plus 2 times 0 equals 0. Well, that's just going to give you y squared is 0, and taking the square root of both sides, it's just 0. There's no plus or minus 0. So the y-intercept, when you put in 0 for x, you got 0 for y. Now, if you want to get the x-intercepts, you're going to put in 0 for y into the same thing. Same equation, right? So we've got x squared plus, we're putting in 0 for y this time, 0 squared. Let's see, plus 2x equals 0. So this gives me x squared plus 2x equals 0, and then we factor. Remember, when you have an x squared term, you always want to set it equal to 0 and factor. So either x equals 0 or x equals 2, I'm sorry, x equals negative 2. So those would give me, when you put in 0 for y, x could be 0, or when you put in 0 for y, x could be negative 2. Notice you get the same exact. So this is an algebraic way of doing it. We're going to get the same x and y-intercepts, but of course, it was easier to graph at first and just visually note where they were. Right, so we did it all. We put it in standard form. We found the center. We found the radius. We stated the x-intercepts, the y-intercept, and we drew the graph. And if I just said, what are the intercepts? You would just say negative 2, 0, and 0, 0, right? I just like listed them so you would It's not like there are three different intercepts, right? Because I have 0, 0 for both of these. So there's another example for you. Where you're giving something that's not quite looking like general form, but close enough. Once you divide by 3, it looks exactly like general form. We go through completing the square, and we're able to answer all those questions. And finish the problem. Okay, now we haven't done any problems where I've given you like the diameter or where I've given you some other point on the circle. There's a lot of other tricky questions you could be asked about how to get the correct equation of a circle. And so look to the next videos if you want to see some trickier types of problems. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.